transform pain to power, not just for ourselves, but for the larger community.
So put together the time you spend in that jail and the time that you spend roaming into manhood at the Panther Party. Did that also create your road to activism, but in a different way? Showed a different result?
It's true. You know, one of the things that, and a lot of us remember those times of protests and whether it was taking over college campus or working in breakfast programs or just standing up to injustice in the war. But the thing that was the real motivating factor, I think if you talk to activist folks and movement folks and say, what was that really about? They'll come back to this. We love the community. We love people. And we realize that we've looked at a child in any community that was going hungry, that was suffering, that didn't have opportunity, then we were all suffering.
And I love the idea of teaching critical thinking. I think that's truly missing in our society a little bit. And I sat with some of your wonderful young charges at lunch today, and they were talking about love and about understanding and about forgiveness. But first of all, they highly respect you and they love you even more, Uncle Jamal.
Uncle Jamal. Who founded the program with me. The thing that they understand is that they are able today to live their lives victoriously, to dream beyond any limitations, to love beyond prejudices, and to serve now. As we like to say, in fact, there is no start date for activism and for our brothers and sisters in the Encore movement, there's no expiration date when that happens.
Definitely is a
replication. You know, the whole idea is, can you, and when Boza and Joyce, my wife and I, started the program, as artists and activists, we knew what was important is not only to live the legacy, but to create something that would exist beyond us. One week we got to Impact late. It was our Saturday afternoon program, and I got there a little bit late, and the young people were there, and this is the leadership portion, and they said, Uncle Jamal, you're here. We're so glad, and I got nervous because I was a little late. I said, yes, I'm here. He said, we need you. And I said, yes, what's wrong? I thought it was a class. I thought it was something. And he said, did you bring your car? And I said, yes. I brought my car, and he said, could you go pick up lunch? The class is there. That's leadership in action. That's really passing.
Yes, exactly.
So,
has that helped as you look around the bend for yourself? Has it made a transition for you? From where you started in that young man on the journey, and here you are now?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, we thought, and this being the 50th anniversary period of so many things, of you know, the Voting Rights Act, which is in danger, the March on Washington, the 50th anniversary of the Black Panther Party, the one weapon of transformation that remains consistent, because at one time we talked about, you know, revolution, and we talked about boycotts, we talked about this, the consistent level of transformation that's alive and well of impact is love. And if you match that with the song, as we say in Impact, the whole world.